Hi, my name is Sascha Ridder, and in today's Innovation Coffee Break, I would like to give you 6 basic tips on how to start modeling properly in AUTOSAR and generate efficient code for your automotive functions. In my view, the most important thing is to maintain an overview of the architectural specifications throughout the entire development process. So let's directly move to the first tip. Well, it might sound very straightforward and basically is a mandatory step to work with TargetLink and AUTOSAR. However, there's tip one. Use the supplied ARXML and store it centrally. The ARXML supplied by an architect contains all the information on the basic structure of the software. This information should be consistently and centrally stored and managed for modeling and subsequent code generation. And in order to do so, import the ARXML into the TargetLink data dictionary to maintain consistency across the architecture and software information. Using the TargetLink data dictionary in general, and specifically in the AUTOSAR use case, due to importing all the information on the AUTOSAR architecture, that guarantees that the information required for modeling is stored centrally for the development process with TargetLink. But what to do after that? How can I now transfer my architecture from the TargetLink data dictionary to the TargetLink model without errors? That brings me to tip 2. Use a frame model generator to generate the model. This keeps the model and the software architecture information in sync. So once all the important information on AUTOSAR has been stored in the TargetLink data dictionary, you can generate a so-called frame model from TargetLink. Here, TargetLink generates a model that contains all the AUTOSAR information required for modeling. And finally, you can now start modeling in TargetLink as usual. But let's stay with the consistency of the model and the architecture. Here I'd like to talk about how you can ensure that consistency is maintained even when the architecture is updated, after modeling or code generation, and how you can check this. And here there are different approaches, which I would like to line out in tip 3. Keep calm and use comparison tools and update mechanisms. Let's imagine the software architect changes the architecture of your software component and delivers to you a new and hence updated ARXML file. At first stage, you have the possibility to directly compare the two versions of the ARXML files with dSPACE AUTOSAR compare. This product gives you a quick overview of the changes within the two ARXML file versions and also allows to integrate your own changes using the merge functionality by dSPACE AUTOSAR compare. And this approach gives you the opportunity to easily and quite early see the differences between the two versions and resolve potential conflicts and merge changes accordingly. From a TargetLink heavy point of view, we also need consistency both in the TargetLink data dictionary and in the model. Again, the TargetLink data dictionary import mechanism is also useful in this update scenario. So when importing an ARXML, you have multiple options to do so. So with an ARXML import in the TargetLink data dictionary, in an already existing TargetLink data dictionary workspace, you can either directly update existing TargetLink data dictionary properties, or, but much more safer, you can first import the updated ARXML into a new TargetLink data dictionary workspace. And here you can then trigger a comparison of the two TargetLink data dictionary workspaces, and hence, of course, the two ARXMLs. And once the code has been generated, you should check again consistency between the ARXML created by TargetLink and the ARXML specified by the architecture. At that point, you can, of course, compare the result with dSPACE AUTOSAR compare again and do some merging if necessary. So we come to tip 4. Test your AUTOSAR models and software as early as possible. TargetLink with its mill, sill, pill test functions has offered good and simple ways of testing software components in the development environment for decades, both in non and AUTOSAR use cases. So let's start with sill and pill. Here, of course, testing is obviously difficult because clearly an RTE or an adaptive middleware is needed here because the software, the generated software, has implemented appropriate calls for the interaction with a classic RTE or adaptive middleware. TargetLink provides functionality for this specific test use case. So while generating code for classic AUTOSAR, TargetLink also generates a non-production RTE. We call this stub RTE for sill tests in TargetLink. It mimics communication via the RTE, although it does not even yet exist on production level. A similar approach applies to the adaptive AUTOSAR use case, although it is still clearly more complicated than for classic AUTOSAR. However, once again, even for adaptive AUTOSAR, TargetLink provides assistance to test early in the development environment. TargetLink encapsulates the middleware calls in the software via compiler macros in such a way that in sill mode on your local machine, the communication is mapped directly via internal communication within the adaptive AUTOSAR function. And this abstraction layer allows you to test your software quickly, easily, and cost-effectively in both AUTOSAR use cases. That brings me to tip 5. Use signal injection for status signals in mill, sill, pill, such as return values from either RTE API functions or calls to the adaptive AUTOSAR middleware. Even if the RTE, the adaptive AUTOSAR middleware, or some functions such as the mentioned server replying to a call is not yet available at the time of the first software tests, it is still possible to simulate that with a signal injection with TargetLink. Using the so-called sender or receiver comspec blocks in TargetLink models, it is possible to simulate the RTE status, signal invalidations, transformer error logic, or adaptive AUTOSAR error handling, among other things. And this gives you the possibility to test your own component very early in the development stage on your local machine. But even on a more complex level, you can still test quite a bit in TargetLink if you use the available onboard resources. So finally, let me introduce you to tip 6. Simply do the first overall software test in your development environment. With TargetLink 5.2, we introduced the first support of importing and generating AUTOSAR software component compositions into TargetLink. And that means with a push of a button, you can import AUTOSAR software component compositions into the TargetLink data dictionary, generate a frame model, and use the update mechanism to ease your own efforts to simulate the software functionality in a more complex interaction with other software components, which in return gives you the chance to test the system in terms of a first rudimentary test in Simulink and TargetLink. But as mentioned before, really complex tests where the production RTE is needed or you want to test the software with an environment model, this all should be done in a virtual test solution such as the dSPACE sill testing solution or in hardware tests. Now, before I would like to end here, here is a final advice. There are a lot of additional things which can be done with TargetLink in terms of AUTOSAR. For years, there is an additional free of charge tooling that provides some blocks, helper tools and comfort functionality, the TargetLink AUTOSAR utilities. For example, there are special block libraries that consist of blocks for NVRAM that allows for generating required RTE calls for the NVRAM manager, E2E protection, or blocks that provide RTE calls such as RTE enter, RTE exit, or RTE trigger, just to name a few. Further, the utilities provide some comfort functions to create an operation call subsystem automatically from the TargetLink data dictionary, a dialog to added properties of RTE events, or just to simplify settings for some ARXML import and export options in the TargetLink data dictionary. These utilities are available for download on our webpage, also including some additional demo models that show you how to handle, for example, NVRAM, or embed incrementally generated non-AutoSAR model fragments into AutoSAR software components. You will find the link to the download page in the show notes. These are, of course, a lot of information, and I did not go into much technical depth. I hope, however, that after that little excursion into the AutoSAR modeling world, nobody is afraid of AutoSAR anymore. I hope that it has become clear that by using MBD in the AutoSAR use case, you can also take advantage of all the benefits of the model-based development world. And at that point, I would like to refer to our tutorial videos, our excellent documentation section, especially the AutoSAR modeling guide, and the demo models that are included in our documentation. And, of course, my colleagues from TargetLink support and engineering. In this sense, thanks for listening, and I hope you learned something new about AutoSAR and TargetLink. And if I could arouse your interest in AutoSAR software development with TargetLink, just write to me to get into a deeper conversation about it.